Hello everyone, welcome to this options talk 27 between Raghunath and me. Today there is a difference. Raghunath will be take a back seat. Of course, he is here online because we have a guest today and about whom I'll talk after I finish my normal weekly roundup. So here is the roundup. I talked about the market being bullish and that is proved, and I mean it's going on and on and on. So there is if you remember, there was a target of 13,200 over here, which has been achieved. The first count has been achieved yesterday. Whether the second count will be achieved, of course, it is anyone's guess. The way market is going, you can't say anything. So first count was 13,230, which was achieved yesterday. That's all I can say right now. Where it will stop, a lot of people are saying where it will stop, no one has any idea. When it will stop, no one has any idea. So all the theories go for a toss here. We had also talked about look out for the pharma sector, and that has given a breakout now. In fact, the sector churning has been quite amazing in this bull run of last few months. One sector takes a backseat and suddenly now banks and pharma are breaking out. I remember pharma was here just near the trend line last week, and I had talked about crossing 12,000, and now it is 12,350. So of course, led by Sun Pharma, some amount of Dr. Reddy, and most of the stocks. Sun Pharma was the leader, I guess. So that also helped. Then I had also talked about this 13,000 call. Why 13,000? A lot of people ask me when market is at 13,100, 13,200, why 13,000? First of all, it is a round number, number one. And number two, it is the strike price is in the long duration options. I mean, if you go to a daily chart over here, this was traded even in Jan 2019 here. So there is a lot of liquidity, lot of trades have taken place. And now you can see, last time I had showed only the intraday chart and I had talked about this level of 380. Now it has crossed and closed at 432. And now what will happen next? So these highs from January 2019, before COVID, before the pandemic, when last time Nifty was 12,200, 300, this had made a high near 600, 620. So logically, that should be the target, at least, that is a resistance. I'm not saying that is a target, but if someone is long, he can trail it to that level. That's why I had not shown the daily chart. I showed it just now, and that's why 13,000 is important, because these options are traded since the last 1 year. Apart from that, the Nifty intraday chart, everything is bullish. I mean, there is nothing bearish to talk about at all. But of course, you need to be cautious. Another chart which I've been constantly showing, VIX is still there, 17, 18, 19, 17, 18, 19, not doing anything at all. Of course, it is not collapsing below 17. So that is something which you need to see. Coming to stocks, one stock which has been completely sideways over the last almost 2 weeks has shown signs of a breakout yesterday. Axis Bank, this is a 630 call. So this made a base. In fact, you can see sort of a triple bottom, which we call a pattern retest, and there were bearish columns, anchor columns here, which have been negated yesterday. So this base of 15 to 17 acts as a support. So of course, that will be a stop loss. And right now it is 22.25. It can go towards 28 or even 35. So look out for Axis Bank. Another stock which has been everyone's favorite for the last so many months, ITC. So this is something interesting which I observed last week, and I'm completely baffled by this. I have no idea why this is happening. Last month in November, I had talked about the 200 open interest at the 200 call, and that was huge, more than 1 crore. Even in December, I mean, we are just near the 1 week has gone, and even now the 200 call has an open interest of 1.05 crores. These three are the open interest. These three lines are the open interest of 200, 205 and 210 calls. 200 call is 1.05 crores. 205 call is 30 lakhs. 210 call is another 72 lakhs. So between the three strike prices, there is a open interest of 2 crores. That is huge. I mean, I have never seen something like this ever in my life. So if anyone is bullish in ITC, you need to keep an eye on this. Of course, if it crosses and this OI starts coming down, then you can see a huge euphoric rise in ITC. But I mean, normally high OI levels act as resistance, but there are cases when it is crossed, then all these guys have to cover, and once they cover, then ITC can shoot up above 210 very fast. So this OI will give an indication of all the three strike prices, 200, 205 and 210. That's all from my side in terms of update. Two stocks for to watch out for Axis Bank and ITC throughout December. Now coming to this week's guest, he is a person very active on Twitter, and I have always wondered whether his Twitter handle was based on Kiran, but that is not the case. It is ZZZUNE, Junaid, because he clarified to me that that was something different reason, and I make him the presenter now. And he has a very interesting strategy of trading straddles, and that too in Bank Nifty, where a lot of people are scared. So over to you, Junaid. I'm making you the presenter now.
Thank you very much, sir, for that short introduction. Good morning, everybody. I'll be sharing my screen. Sir, let me know when you guys are able to see my
Yeah,
screen.
Raghunath and me will ask you questions, so we'll just interrupt you when you talk.
Definitely.
Go ahead. We can see the screen.
Right. So like everybody knows that there is nothing right or wrong in the market. All that we know is what works for us, right? So I will talk about what works for me, what I have done. There are multiple strategies that everybody continues to trade on, but there are some few strategies which are close to your heart, and there is some rules and methods that you use. So I'll only talk about that, what I do. So my trading book contains two things. One is directional and non-directional strategies. They run in my account, and that is how when the market is moving in one directional strategy will make me money, and non-directional, all I have to ensure that I don't lose in non-directional strategies. Whereas when the market is not moving, the non-directional makes money, and in directional I definitely will lose a little bit of amount in whipsaws. So overall, I need to ensure that I am taking home some money every month in whichever instrument I trade. So that's the reason why I trade directional and non-directional strategies together in the market. So what we'll do is today we'll talk about the non-directional strategies on index. Like I said, there's nothing right or wrong, and there are many strategies. We'll talk about some things which are close to my heart. Let me jump on to the rules for non-directional. I'll talk about Bank Nifty, right? So I'll take these points again in my next slides when I explain an example, but just a quick recap. Enter 7 to 8 days before expiry, weekly expiry, and exit the trade preferably one day before the expiry. If you exit it on the expiry day also, that is absolutely fine. If you exit 2 days before also, that is absolutely fine. If your overall profit targets are met, you can exit it at that time. However, this is preferable. Why I don't exit on the expiry day is because expiry days are very wild, and I don't want to lose the money that I have gained in the last 5 6 days. So that's an opportunity loss, so I don't want to lose on that. On monthly, I generally tend to start the month monthly strategies on the next day of the expiry, monthly expiry, right? So I get 30 days to make the adjustment. Now, why so early? The question is that why so early, when the premiums generally fall in the last 10 days of monthly expiry, and why so early on weekly as well, 7 or 8 days before, when the premiums actually fall only 2 3 days before the weekly expiry? So the explanation to this from my side is that when I enter early, I get a very big range to play around with. So my break-even points are so wide that I get a lot of time and a lot of space to make the adjustment, because my first entry is generally not going to make me money, but my subsequent entries in the same strategy will make me money. So I'll explain to you later on in the couple of slides. So my entry criteria is only one thing, right? Straddle. So after the days, then the next entry criteria is straddle. Straddles are basically the most powerful method in the market to identify whether the market is going to trend or it is going to remain in a certain range. Straddle range is so powerful. I mean, first of all, straddles are something that we learned from Abhijit sir only. In 2014, 13, 14, I remember that I learned straddles from him, the importance of straddles from him, and we understood a lot of realities about straddle. So straddle range is so big, you know, at the start of the month, and if the market breaks one side of the range of a straddle, that side of the market is very strong. So if it breaks on the upside, then market tends to remain on that side for that entire month. Last week we saw max pain, right? So if the max pain is rising continuously, and if the straddle, if the you know, spot prices break one range of this break even of straddle, you have to believe that the market is going to end in that direction, probably at the extreme ends, right? So that's how powerful straddles are. So here the entry criteria for shorting premium and gaining out of the premium decay is that the straddles must fall. It should be below certain EMA, and it should be or it should have crossed the EMA, right, on the downside. So that is one criteria. I'll show it to you on the next slide. Preferably you check at the money, and you check the the near ATM straddles. Next slide we will see that as well. Now, extremely important point, the last point, very, very important for my style at least. I don't enter my entire capital in the first go. I enter it very, very slowly, because when the market, when a series starts, right, the market will not remain at that stage itself. It will move either on the downside, it will move on the upside. It will 90%, 80% of the times it will break, it will go to the extreme end, it will break the break even. So believing that you entered a strategy and the market will remain in that range and you'll make money is not right. The market will break the other side. Now that's the whole game. When the market breaks the other side, that is one of the break even points. That's the point when you let it break. You know, I let it break. I pray that, okay, please break that break even point, because that's the point when I'll actually start making money by entering more positions, by adding up more positions. And believe me, I mean, it is very short a time to explain all these, the concepts to you, but believe me, you'll start observing this as well, you know. So I start very slowly. I start with one fourth or one fifth sometimes of position. So let's say that I have 10 lakh of capital. So I will keep around 2 to 3 lakh on directional strategy, and I will allocate around 5 to 6 lakhs on non-directional strategies, and keep 1 to 2 lakh in spare just in case, you know. And non-directional 6 lakhs also, I will start the position with 1 to 1.5 lakh rupees, and then slowly and steadily in a day to 2 days, I will keep adding and adjusting. I need money to, I need capital in spare to make the adjustments.
Junaid, just one question before going. If you can go back to a previous slide. So here, when you said 1/4 or less capital, which means, are you going to do 4 positions in general, or you're saying that for this whole trade, don't use more than 1/4 in general?
Yeah. So entry. So start slowly. You know. So what I'm saying is that start. Let's say that you've got 10 lakh of capital, and 6 lakhs you have allocated for Bank Nifty weekly expiry trade. Okay. So your first entry on the 7 days or 8 days before should be 1/4 of your 6 lakh capital.
Okay, got it.
So which means that around 1.5 lakh rupees you will start the entry on probably Wednesday or Thursday of the Tuesday, Wednesday or Thursday of every week. Okay. Right? And so when days pass, you will keep adding 1/4 part each. Okay. Yeah.
So it's a position.
Just one point from my side. When you said 10 lakh, I mean, this is not a question to you. This is a caution to viewers, because when he said 10 lakh, that means the allocated trading capital. It's not the total capital, because 1.5 lakhs is something which you need for shorting one lot straddle. You need much more available for cushions. So in fact, what generally is the case is 3 to 4 lakhs for one lot of straddle. That is what you should have in your account. isn't it, Junaid?
Correct. That's right. Yes.
Yeah.
By the way, just a quick this thing. The strategy is basically not the straddle. The entry criteria is straddle. Since straddle being a very like in price action, price is a very important factor, right? Similarly, in you know option strategy, I feel straddles are the most important price action you know that we have to see. So that's straddles are something that helps me make a decision on entering a strategy. What would be the position? Whether it will be a strangle, whether it will be a calendar, whether it will be a mixed strategy, that we will see in the next slide. Yeah. Now, rules to build the strategic position. First of all, whenever you are building a position on, you know, 7th or 8th day of a weekly expiry or 30th day, you should ensure that the break-even is very large, you know. So if you get that break, if the break even is very large on the 7th day or 8th day, you can basically enter the position. You know, it becomes very easy for you to enter the position. However, like for example, you've missed the day, right? Friday, Thursday and Friday were holidays. Monday you are entering a position. By Monday the premiums drop and the range becomes very small. So you should not enter. You should not, you know, leave that week. You should not, you know, enter a strategy or try to trade every week, every day, right? So leave it. So ensure that you are entering on a big range. So you, this left hand side and right hand side that you see, these are the from green to red. That those are the break even points. You must have seen this on you know Raghu's many videos. So this is what I'm talking about, that the straddle range should be very, very big. Minimum 2% on weekly and minimum 5% on monthly. Now these days, since the ATR of Bank Nifty is very high, big, the range is big. So we are getting even bigger ranges like 7 or 8% on monthly on Bank Nifty and 3%, 2.5, 3, 4% sometimes on weekly. But generally, this is the average rate that you should at least look at. If it is below that, better not enter the trade. Yeah, rules to build a strategic position, ensure range is of the break even is large. Second thing that you need to look at is that the position that you make, now this is interesting, position that you make is adjustable both sides. So the idea here is that if it breaks the break even point on the upside, you should be able to adjust the position and you know make the delta even leaner, make the delta, bring the deltas closer to zero, bring the payoff chart at in the center as much as possible. But if it breaks on the downside, still you should be able to adjust the position in a similar manner. So the position should be adjustable on both sides, right? So that's one important one. Build a limited, we'll by the way see that example. Build a limited risk position. Straddles are unlimited risk positions. So entering a straddle is a daredevil thing. It's not something that cannot be done, should not be done. I'm saying that straddle is a unlimited risk position, but you can build limited risk position also, you know. So what are the strategies meeting these criteria? So one such strategy is that you short the near money expiry. Like for example, you can short weekly expiry straddles. Okay, weekly expiry straddle. So example is short 29,500 call and put of weekly expiry. At the same time, you buy out of money or you buy monthly strangles, right? So you buy 28,500 put and 30,500 call of monthly expiry. So this way you are basically limiting your risk, the loss, whereas you are taking advantage of the fast fall in premium of the near expiries, right? So this is one of the strategy that falls under this criteria, right?
And this call and put strike price, yeah, for buying the strangle, is there any basis or just 1,000 points on either side?
Yeah, there is no basis as such. The break even point, generally what I do is I select the break even point. So like for example, okay, if you add on the payoff chart 29,500 call and put on weekly chart, you will see that the break evens are at 28,500 and 30,500. So I would pick up those strikes and buy monthly expiry strikes, right? So that's okay. That's what I do. So if the break evens are probably 200 points low when this volatility period stops probably next year, the range will be smaller. So that time I will pick 200 points nearer expiry to buy the monthly calls and puts.
In monthly options, what I have observed is only the 500 strike prices are liquid. I mean, if the break even comes to, let's say, 28,700, would you still buy that or you prefer 500s apart?
Yeah, that's a problem with Bank Nifty. So if I get this strategy very near to 500, I will do it. But this strategy you can do very well on any Nifty strikes. So you can do that thing on Nifty strikes. But yeah, I understand that it is difficult to get a Bank Nifty for other strikes. But recently, AP sir, if you have seen you're getting it at a very small spread also. The liquidity has gone up somehow. Let's see how it goes after this rule change. But as of now, in the last many months, we've been getting good liquidity. And fills also, not much, like monthly expiry, far off strikes also, 5-point strikes is maximum that we are getting, 5-point spread.
Okay.
The second set that can be taken is, same thing, straddle short, near expiry straddle short, and far expiry. So this is basically a calendar spread, both call and put calendar spread, right? So you short near expiry and you long far expiry, right? But you do it for both call as well as put. Yeah, I hope this is clear. I will take an example. I hope this is clear. No questions at this point.
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah. Now let's look at how to enter a strategy, right? So first, what I do is I plot straddles of multiple strike, right? At the money, some strikes above at the money and some strikes below at the money. Which means that if the market is at 29,500, then I will plot 29,000. I will plot 29,500 straddle. I will plot 30,500 straddle, and I'll also plot 30,500 straddle. This is what I did, right? Last time. Now I have to pick, any strike which is near money. So I see that when I entered the strike, all three, 29,000, 29,500, and 30,000, all strikes were falling below. The straddles were falling. Now what is this EMA, right? This white line EMA that you see, that is 34 EMA. Okay. So in trade point, there is AMA also. So you can plot AMA 34 period AMA also. By the way, this is trade point web. So trade point web has a beautiful feature of showing this multi charts on the screen, and many benefits. One is it is real time. Second, very big benefit for me as a retail trader is that it is affordable, right? Monthly charges are very, very low. And it gives me very rich features like these. And very big another feature is that I can actually plot multi-legs, right? I can plot straddle, strangles of any expiry, any combination. So if I take a position like a 4 or 6 leg position, I can actually plot those all positions here and see how the performance of that particular set combination is. So this is web trade point use.
Basically, you're saying plot all those 6 leg as one single line chart.
Yeah, that we can do. Yes, yeah. On that. Yeah. So here on the chart, you see all the straddles, right? All 4 straddles. Now this is what keeps running on my machine on one of the screens, right? So I can pick any, by the way, but I am picking near the money, 29,000, right? Now I'm taking this example because I went wrong in this trade, right? And it's the best thing to learn, right?
Before going
this was
ahead,
yesterday?
Once, no, this was this on second. This was on yeah, the chart is of yes, third December.
Yeah.
I had taken you know, position on 2nd December approximately, because that time all the strikes, the straddles were falling.
Yeah.
So this screenshot was taken yesterday morning, I believe.
Okay.
Yeah, points to remember: when you build a make a position, put it on you know, the chart, see the payoff, see that things are very good, the range is big and everything, don't enter immediately, right? When once you have prepared, all your criteria are meeting, still, you know, I like to walk out of the room, get up the seat and just walk out, spend 5 minutes outside, right? Come back, take a fresh look at that same position, whether the situation still remains, am I in the mindset to take that position again or not? If the answer is yes, I will enter the position, right? So don't hurry up, right? Second point of caution is that don't keep adjusting every day, every hour, every minute. Only adjust when the position hits the break even. That is, it went goes from green to red, the payoff chart. That is the only time you adjust the position. You wait, you know, it probably you may have to wait for days together. So it's okay. That's a point of caution. So this is how the trade looked like. I took the position and next day I took it on 2nd December, and next day itself, I think I took it on 3rd December, I don't remember. But next day itself, it hit the break even. So this was on weekly, right? It hit the break even point. So now I have to do the adjustment, because my rule says that once it hits the break even point, I have to do the adjustment. Now, like I said, both sides, whether it goes up or down, it must be adjustable. So here, what I'll do is I will book the leg, the 29,000 put short leg, because that's in profit, right? Let the spot hit break even. So what I'll do is first I will adjust the put leg, the profitable leg. I will exit that position and I will roll it up to 30,000, because market had hit 30,000 very fast yesterday, right? So I hit the position, I rolled up the position to 30,500, and the position now looks like this. Not much of a benefit, but now I am, you know, now I am again in the center. If the market does not move anywhere, I am going to earn money out of it, little bit, whatever money I am earning. Now this is part number one out of that four parts that I talked about. This is part number one only. And I have also pushed the break even further up to 30,300, right? So that's the adjustment. Now comes the part where I have to enter the second part, right? I was only one part in the trade. Now I go back to the straddle again, and I see that which strike is falling. So I see that my original 29,000 is rising, so I can't trade anymore in that. 29,500 is also rising and it is above the EMA, so I can't trade that also. 30,000 is something that is now started falling, and it is continuously falling, and even 30,500. But 30,000 is near the money, at the money. So I can take a second position in this. Now, what do I do is I take a second position. I am adding my second part as calendar spread, right? So I sold 30,000 calls and I bought 30,000 calls of weekly expiry, and I bought 30,000 calls of monthly expiry. Now this is how this payoff looks like. My maximum profit has now come to you know, probably market ended around 30,300. I don't remember exactly, 30,200 or 150 or odd, but it is somewhere here. So I have made this entire position delta neutral. Okay, so invariably it happened, and now I have a break-even point, which is around 2% on the upside and around 2% on the downside. So this is only on two positions. Now remember that I still have two more positions to enter, right? The situation is not bad. So this is the example that I wanted to show to you, that how a position is entered by meeting certain criteria. Number one, you enter when the market is wide. Number one. Number two, you enter when you know, around 7 to 8 days before on the weekly expiry. Number three, you enter slowly, so you start taking 1/4 position. Don't enter everything. If you enter everything, you have left nothing to make the adjustment. You have to exit the position in loss, and that's not the idea to be in the market, right? Not to trade in loss. So enter the position slowly and steadily. Number four, very important, is that you have to make the position which is adjustable on both sides, on the upside as well as on the downside. No matter where the market goes, on the upside you can adjust. No matter if the market falls down 2%, 3% overnight, you still will be able to adjust the position. Yeah, have I left anything? Yeah, so these are the points that you have to always remember. And of course, you know, it's a limited risk position, and you can keep adding more protection to it. Now, exit criteria. There is no written down rule. Generally, you know, 30 to 50% of the, when I reach maximum profit, like for example, the maximum profit is 30,000. Okay. So when I reach 10,000, 15,000, I start scaling down. I start reducing my overall set position. It is very difficult to execute scaling down because you've got multiple legs. So, you know, I have to be very careful when exiting positions. I should not be making mistakes and making the entire position tilted to one side. Or I can exit the entire position when I reach around 30% or 40% of the total maximum profit. When the position, there are times when the position is not adjustable at all. No matter what you do, no matter how much you know, profitable legs you keep rolling up, no matter how much positions you keep adding, calendar key you keep adding, it is no more adjustable. You are not going to get much out of it. So better to exit the position, take that hit, take that small loss and get out. Because next week, definitely, how long will the market keep trending, right? It has to stop. These days the market, so the original rule is that 70% of the time markets trend, 30% of the time the market don't trend. These days it's 50-50. 50% of the markets are trending, 50% of the markets are not trending. Exceptional days, but it's okay. You know, when the markets don't trend and keeps whipping around, you're going to get a huge amount of premium gain, like what happened in last week of November. The gain was so steep on premiums that a good amount of money was earned in the last week of November. Exit a day before expiry. That's what my rule is. You can, you know, look for other rules also. This is general observation. Fall in premiums, you know, this gives a good hint on when to exit a particular set of position. 9:15 to 9:30, minor decrease or minor increase in premium happen. You know, premiums increase when there is trend during this period also, right? Because the market has just started. But 10:30 to 1 p.m. I have observed that nothing happens. Very, very less, you know, very less premium drop happens. Very less premium increase sometimes happen. Trending day is an exception. But otherwise, nothing happens between 10:30 to 1 p.m. 1 p.m. to 2:30 and 3 p.m., the premium drops are steep. The market, you would have seen that market whips also very fast during that time. You know, either it takes one side on the upside or on the downside. But this is the time when the market falls and then, you know, rises back. The premium drops are very, very steep, right? So 1 to 3 p.m. And after 3 p.m. to 3:30 p.m., market again goes into a still mode. And nothing happens because players are building new positions. So 10:30 to 1 p.m. when nothing is happening, I am spending time in you know, in on Opstra. I put a lot of positions. I do a lot of adjustment. I use that nothing happening time to see what I can do next, my next steps. And those, I believe that is what many pro traders also do. I'm not a pro, but many pro traders also do, and they start building the position after 3 to 3:30 p.m. And because, you know, they have to build a new position and they can carry it for the next next day, next week, next month. So that is how I have observed from the fall and rise of the premium. So to exit the entire position, you can you know, exit between around 2:30 to 3 p.m. when the premiums have fallen very steep. So that's about it. This was one you know, strategy that I thought that I could cover in the time that I have. So you have any questions on this?
Yes, Junaid. If you go to
yes,
the
sir.
Previous slide.
Yes.
Sorry. The,
yes.
Yeah. So in the next adjustment, when you added the second position, you have added one long 30,000 call only. You have not added another. Is this by the design?
Yeah, it is by the design because I still have two more parts now to enter, and you know, I am waiting for the market now to do something on Monday, right? Either it can fall and 2% and come to 29,200, which is the downside, which is the lower side break even, or if it breaks 30,500, which is the upside break even. So I don't want to use my capital unnecessarily to, you know, and block the capital when I don't know whether market will move on the on Monday and Tuesday. So when it moves, I will add up more position, probably add same position, right? But I will do it on Monday. So my position adding is steady.
Okay. So basically, you are ready to add up to four positions, right?
Right. Four, five. Yeah. But not more than five. So idea here is that if you are not profitable in five entries, right? So five, these are five individual trades. If you are not profitable in four or five entries, then you will not be profitable in that trade. So better not to take any more trades and just exit. You know, there is another trade waiting for you next week. So I have seen people taking trades and doing adjustments 8, 10, 15 times also. I mean, how long will you keep rolling your not working position? So my rule is that 4 to 5 times maximum, that's allowable.
And also when you do this with monthly, for example, you know, you said you also do this with weekly. Sometimes you also do with monthly.
Yeah, monthly and I do it for Nifty.
Nifty. Okay.
Yeah, bank Nifty, you know, next. So if I am want to do a calendar, right? If I sell December month,
before
I want to buy January. Yeah.
Here you have, I mean, since this is relevant to the current slide, here you have taken the original position is the weekly straddle short 29,000, right?
That is correct. Yes.
And so that will expire on 10th. So after that, what happens?
I will exit this entire position and I will entire position. I will not, you know, exit individual legs. This entire position is gone. So it's like erasing your entire memory, right? You start.
I thought you will enter fresh at the money straddle on for 17th. I thought that way.
Yeah. No. I will exit this entire thing and then I will go back to my rule sheet, right? My rule sheet again starts fresh. So I will go to that straddle chart first. I will see what are the at the money straddles falling and then I will enter a new position. There is a possibility that I might have to end. Yeah,
that will be on Friday 11th December fresh position.
No, that will be on either 9th or 10th of December.
Oh yeah, sorry. Yeah.
So coming back to Raghu's question, why I don't do monthly calendar on Bank Nifty is because, you know, January month you try to buy something, you'll not get only the spreads are too so high. So but Nifty definitely, I mean Nifty March puts also you can puts and calls also you can buy, so you have good liquidity in Nifty. That's why.
Yes. Okay. And another question was, for Nifty, so for Nifty you do the same, but you do with monthly expiries.
You do that the is same correct. That is correct. Yes. So doing Nifty on monthly makes sense. Doing Nifty, doing Bank Nifty on weekly makes sense, right? So that's the that's how the positions can be built on indexes.
And here your target is it based on time? So you exit on Wednesday. After you enter this position, you exit on Thursday and you don't have any prefixed target, right?
Yeah, no prefixed target. 30 to 50% either whichever hits first, right? 30 to 50% of the total max profit. So now you can see the max profit is like 12,000 in this entire in this one single set. I may have utilized around 80,000 rupees in this entire set,
position.
Right? Mm-hmm. Per set, 80,000 rupees. So if you're trading, so multiplied by that numbers. But the total max profit is 12,000, which is 16%. Now 16% in 1 week is very, very high. So what I'll do is I'll exit when I hit 4,000 or 5,000 maximum. I will exit this entire position, which is like probably 4-5% of the entire capital that I have deployed.
Okay. So have you considered in this model? Have you considered the risk of volatility in this case?
See, straddle. Okay, good question. Actually, I'll tell you. You know, straddle is so powerful that the IVs. If you plot IVs and you plot straddle, at the money straddle, they are basically, they will follow the same trend. So if the at the money straddles are rising, you will also see that the IV chart on IV chart that they are rising. If you see IVs falling, you will also see that the straddles are falling. So straddles and IV basically, so I am not a Greek trader, by the way, right? I understand Greek, but it is too much for me, you know, too many parameters to look into. Delta, gamma, vega, theta, and all those things. So it is, and IVs and IV rank and percentile and so many things, you know, skews and everything. So there are so many parameters, it becomes very difficult for me to keep tracking, keep making decisions. For me, straddle, one single chart gives me the entire picture of my entry, right? Whether I want to enter or whether I don't want to enter, one single chart, that's it. So it becomes my life, you know, it makes my life easy. So yeah, volatility definitely I have to look at, but straddle is taking care of volatility for me on that. Like I showed you this chart, right? 29,000 and 29,500, both are rising. You see, if you see, two straddles are rising, two straddles are falling. Whereas if you actually see the previous entry time, see, all the straddles are falling. This is the time you'll also see that the IVs would be falling.
Yeah.
This is the time where you'll see that the IVs probably have started to rise somehow. Mm. You'll also see during the previous time, you go and check your volatility skew. I have not checked, but you go and check your volatility skew and volatility skew percentile. Probably they will be at the lowest. And yesterday end, you would have seen that they have started rising now again. Right. So what I'm trying to say here is that all the parameters of Greeks are taken care by straddles.
Okay, the strategy
is great. Yeah, taking care it's of a them. Great. It's a great gift to us, the non-Greek people, and thanking Abhijit sir to introduce me also. We worked a lot on straddles during 2014-15. I created Ztrend based straddle also. We studied a lot on that. Yeah, but it covers a lot of things. Yes.
Just one point for viewers. You mentioned it was a 34 EMA and the time frame is 15 minutes. That is important.
Yes. Thank you, sir. 15 minutes. I did not mention earlier. Noticed it, I guess. Yes.
That would have been a logical EMA question by hundreds of people to you. So I'm answering it right now.
Yeah, that's right. 15 minutes time frame and 34 EMA.
Okay, Junaid, it's an amazing strategy. It's very nicely explained. Thank you for explaining so well.
Thank you for having me, MP sir.
Yeah. Our viewers have benefit from this strategy and this explanation. However, they might choose to use this. So, AP, do you have any other questions?
Yeah, just one comment. I mean, it's in a positive manner, not negative, not criticism. But my first reaction was basically take Sabudana on a Wednesday, Thursday, and by next Thursday, cook a delicious khichdi.
Okay. Yes, that's what will happen if we have, you know, very disciplined way of trading here. That is what will happen.
Because you'll have 4-5 legs open. So that's why the khichdi name came to my mind immediately looking at the legs.
Yes, true. Thank you very much for having me.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Junaid. It was a wonderful session and I'm sure viewers will benefit. And I'm also sure you will. I request you to keep in touch with the YouTube channel, because once we upload a video, a lot of people comment there in terms of questions. So if you find something which you can answer straight away, please do that.
Definitely, I will do that. Sure.
Yeah.
Thank you, Junaid.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.